if we ever will. Harvest time is not only a time of great consequence, but it's also a time of great effort. And in the effort, we have to be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that our labor is not in vain in the Lord. We must work if we're going to reap the harvest. The question is, the topic is, the harvest is plentiful, but are you willing to be used? We've got to know and understand here that workers are few. Jesus is only one laborer. He can only personally share with a small, if I may, number of people his plan for reaping. The rest of the harvest is to commission the followers to join in the process of his method, his motivation, and the means. The Bible said in the text that Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues. Want you to know the word teaching. Before there was preaching, they were taught. It's hard to hear preaching if you have no foundation to base the preaching upon. Then the scripture goes on to say that he went on preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. Listen, we are often stuck on the motivation when our focus needs to be on the actual method. We don't take away from the laying on of hands. We don't take away from the anointing with oil. But if there's gonna be healing, there's gonna be teaching and preaching. If disease and sickness is gonna be healed, I've got to close. My God, our ears have got to be opened to the method of God. The Bible goes on to say, but when he saw that, look at a neighbor and say, look, look, look. When he saw the multitude, the Bible says that he was moved with compassion for them because they were weary and scattered. They were weary and scattered because they were hearing, but they were not listening. Not only that, but structure and order were not the priorities of the day. Oh, believer, question is enough. But